Hello everyone and welcome to a new installment of Beyond the Mask. Today I want to analyse the relationship between Billy Loomis and Stu Macher in the original Scream in 1996. Their relationship has often been open to interpretation. However, Kevin Williamson, who wrote the script for Scream in 1996, has actually confirmed a huge detail about their relationship. So in this video today, we're going to be going deep into the analysis of this and actually assessing what he said and explain to you guys why I think what he said is true. So the main reason for this video is to answer this question. Were Billy Loomis and Stu Macher in a homosexual relationship? The answer for that is pretty interesting and it's very divided amongst Scream fans. Some believe that this is obvious, whilst others don't see that on screen and don't tend to sort of take that away from watching the movie. And so assessing this has got to go off what the writer says. So regardless of what people feel about this situation, the writer, Kevin Williamson, has said this. He claims that he based the characters of Billy and Stu off of real-life serial killers from 1924, and those serial killers were Nathan Leopold and Richard Loeb. To understand what he's talking about here, I'm going to have to explain to you about what these serial killers did and what the story was about. So Nathan Leopold and Richard Loeb were two killers in 1924 who planned to commit the perfect murder. So they planned on killing a boy called Bobby Franks, and they set up the whole thing to be this perfectly constructed murder, and it would prove how intellectual they were. That was their gain from the murder. They wanted to prove how clever they were. However, following the actual death of Bobby Franks, in which both of them sort of worked together to kill him, they were found out pretty quick, which proved that their intellect wasn't all that great, and so they ended up getting caught. Now, following the actual capture of them both, Nathan Leopold came out and said that he was in a homosexual relationship with Richard Loeb. It was believed by the police investigators and analyzers of that situation that Richard Loeb was the dominant killer and Nathan Leopold was in love with him. And so this is what Kevin Williamson based his characters of Billy Loomis and Stu Macher off. Here's what Kevin Williamson said when describing the Leopold and Loeb murder case. It was very sort of homoerotic, in the sense that there were these two guys that killed this other person just to see if they could get away with it. One of the reasons that one could get the other one to follow is because I think the other one was secretly in love with him. It was a fascinating case study in double murders. If you Google Leopold and Loeb, you will see and you'll read about it and you'll get, okay, that's Billy and Stu. He then went on to say, is Stu secretly in love with Billy? Maybe. Did Billy manipulate that? Possibly. It's all left up for you to wonder, because Billy is the one who is leading. Billy is the one who had the mother. Billy was the one who was sort of orchestrating it, and Stu was the person who helped carry it out. So it sort of puts Stu in that position of, what was his feelings towards his best friend? After I actually decided to do a video on this, I went back and assessed the movie, and I watched it through and analysed the dynamic between Billy and Stu. I went through the movie and watched it, and I definitely think that you would be kidding yourself if you didn't think there was something there, because there's something between the pair of them that doesn't really add up in terms of their relationship. Now, many people can sort of discuss how, you know, both had girlfriends and both were motivated to get revenge on their girlfriends, and people have their own opinions on this situation, but humans are very complex people. And as someone that studied serial killers, it's not something that's easy to understand how someone's brain ticks or how they believe that, you know, the world is, and they don't see things how we do. And so even though I think that Billy Loomis was definitely the dominant of the two, I do believe that Stu may have had some repressed sexuality issues, and I think that maybe Billy would have manipulated that into sort of doing his own bidding, because Roman Bridger told Billy to get Stu on board to frame him in case he got caught. And that's something that people often overlook about this case. There's a lot of subtext in the relationship between them both. So analysing the stabbing scene in front of Sydney was very telling. You know, it's something that if you sort of Google the reference of being stabbed, it has a different meaning than just simply stabbing each other. And so I think that that was something that was used hidden in subtext. But analysing their relationship was very interesting. I do believe, as I said before, that Billy did use Stu and maybe used his sexuality against him to sort of do his bidding. So what lengths would Billy have gone to have got Stu on board? That's something that I believe is open to interpretation. But I believe the relationship between them both was laced in hatred. And I believe that Billy himself was a very messed up individual. And I believe that he used Stu's vulnerability to do his bidding. And so, with that in mind, it's highly possible that these two were in a homosexual relationship, but it was a planned, orchestrated relationship on Billy's part to manipulate Stu. Thank you very much for watching this video, guys. Don't forget to like this video. It lets me know that you're enjoying this content. Without further ado, I'm going to close this video off on a Billy and Stu moment.
You prefer the term psychotic.
We'll never get away with this.
Well, no. Tell that to Cotton Weary. You wouldn't believe how easy he was to frame.
Watch a few movies, take a few notes. It was fun.
Like scary.